That's who you are, God. That's who you are. Miracle, you are my Come on, somebody. Oh, Heavenly Father, we come to you this morning, first repenting of our sins, sins of omission and sins of commission. Wash us in your blood. We decree and declare that no weapon formed against us will prosper. We decree and declare that our unsaved family members this year will ask the question, what must I do to be saved? We decree and declare that we will put on the whole armor of God so that we can stand against the wiles of the devil. We decree and declare that the fruit of the Spirit will be manifested in every area of our life. We decree and declare that our steps are ordered by thy word, and no iniquities will have dominion over us. We decree and declare that our tongues will be bridled at all times. We decree and declare that we fear God and keep his commandments, for this is the whole duty of man. We decree and declare that we shall love the Lord thy God with all of our heart, with all of our soul, with all of our strength, and with all of thy mind, and love thy neighbor as thyself. We decree and declare that love never fails. We decree and declare that we may prosper and be in good health, even as thy soul prospers. We decree and declare that we are in a paid off church. We make this declaration on this day with mustard seed faith. Amen.
Celebration. You all pray for me that I don't disappoint. I see so many familiar faces of people that are here from near and far, and I tell you, my heart is just bubbling and jumping just seeing these people. As I begin, I'd like you to just take a moment in your mind and think about something that's big, that's huge, that's gigantic. Maybe it's a condition that you had that you're now healed from. Or maybe it's a kid that graduated from college and got a full scholarship and then got a job in the field that they were looking for. Or maybe all your kids got full scholarship. Or maybe the person that won the lottery gave you part of that money. Maybe it's something big, a big inheritance. For me, it would be if they fixed the water in Flint so I could have all the water around all the time. Something that's huge. Well, or maybe it's paying off the church. That to me is ginormous. Nehemiah 4:6 says the people had a mind to work. The reason we can do that today is because we all had a mind to work. I'm here to tell you a story about the occasion. Now, there's a disclaimer. I may have some of these dates wrong, but that's okay. I'm going to start my story like a story, chapter one. I'm going to skip all the way past the introductions, and I'm going to go to chapter one. Chapter one, the number one stands for unity. Please allow me, humor me today, because I want to start once upon a time. Once upon a time in 1952, many years ago, when stamps were 3 cents. My pages are mixed up. When stamps were 3 cents, and milk was 96 cents, and gas was 20 cents, and a car cost you $1,800, and a Harvard education was $600 a year. A man by the name of M.J. Williams, who undoubtedly felt the call of God to unify the people, So he started a church, a place of worship, somewhere where he answered the call to reach the unreachable while impacting the community. During this time, a church was birthed on the south side of Saginaw, on Grant and Yeoman Street. It was called Mount Zion. It was later known as Grant Street Church of God in Christ, and subsequently renamed William Memorial in honor of Pastor Williams. Now that's the beginning. Now let's fast forward for the sake of time to chapter 7. So I'm skipping a lot of stuff, y'all. In 1984, the number 7 is a number that means completion, perfection, and rest. Around 1984, the vision expanded Habakkuk 2 and 2 and unfolded after Bishop Roger Jones appointed the late Bishop Marvin C. Pryor, pastor of Williams Memorial, along with his wife. There's a footnote here. Mother Pryor continues to stand as a pillar and a legacy to this current church, and she works tirelessly. Bishop Pryor was a great man, an awesome man, and he loved people. He took the assignment to lead, and he moved from Flint to Saginaw. I lived in Flint. I hated for him to leave. I hated for them to go. Oh my God, I was not envying Saginaw. I was mad at Saginaw for taking Bishop Pryor from us. He carried on the vision of the men before him, and he lovingly led. With him came growth, property purchases, expansion, remodeling, and mission. William Memorial was later renamed Victorious Believers Ministry in 1993 to reflect the philosophy of victorious living, both spiritually and naturally. It became increasingly necessary after growth to build a bigger, better, more comprehensive place where people could be able to serve in the 21st century, which improved facilities, enhanced abilities, easy access, and meet the needs of the total man. He really had a vision. He really had a vision for the people and for the community and for everyone. He believed that salvation plus education equals success. So somewhere around 1999, a new edifice was completed at this location, a design for the future generations and a place to continue God's work. In 2010, after serving in Saginaw for more than 25 years, God called Bishop home and he rested. But man, I bet he up there rejoicing right now. I know he is, because I know it had to be his dream that this church be played off.
Hallelujah.
Chapter 8. The number 8 means new life, new beginning. In 2010, after the passing of the bishop, the Lord blessed the church with a high energy, fun, loving, anointed, praying husband, father, man of God, who continued to pursue the vision. He tell you he don't spend a lot of money. And we've seen that he probably is very conscious of what he spends. And that's been good for us. Pastor Chris is the son of the late Bishop and Evangelist Pryor. He and his intelligent, hard-working, loving wife, Kenyatta, took the reins and worked diligently to pursue the vision. Alive and expanding and growing the church just as his father. Pastor Chris left a successful secular job to serve in the ministry. His love for God and God's people is demonstrated through the 5 pillars of the ministry. And there, I see that they're all up here today. Family, evangelism, missions, discipleship, and community development. We now have approximately 70 ministries to serve family with a mission of passionately seeking God, joyfully serving others, and intentionally loving people. This celebration is not just about paying off the church and burning the mortgage, although a $4.6 billion church is a gigantic accomplishment. It signifies more of a new beginning than the end of death. It really focuses on the now. It positions us for new and exciting things. It's an opportunity to say, well, what's next? What's next? What's next? I want to fast forward to the conclusion. I didn't write a conclusion. With prayer, fasting, and seeking God for answers, you choose your own end.
Thank you. Oh, Yes, he is.
Yes, he is.
Come on, tell him, thank you, Jesus. hands all over the sanctuary. Come on, you may be seated in the presence of the Lord. What a blessing it is to be here on this Vision Sunday 2018. Well, God is good. He is worthy to be praised. He is worthy to be praised. Amen. Come on, I'm excited about today, and I thank God for each and every one of you. Come on, today is a good day. But this is the day that the Lord has made. We shall rejoice and be glad in it. I want to say thank you to each and every one of you. You know how Pastor Chris feels today. I'm overjoyed. I went to bed early so that I could wake up early this morning to get ready to see this new day. Amen. And so I'm excited about it. Today is Vision Day 2018. Come on. The Bible says in Rebecca 2:2 through verse 3. It says, write the vision and make it plain on tablets so they that hear it, they may run with it. For the revelation awaits an appointed time. It shall speak at the end, and it will provide, won't provide, will come to force, to fruition. And so, Father, today, we thank you for who you are and what you continue to do for us. We thank you that you are great, that you are mighty. I remember my father reading that scripture, and I remember him having it. You go to the narthex to the left, you'll see that plastered on our wall, that's what God had given him, to write the vision, to make it plain. We should write it down in detail. And so that make sure that we see it. Those who see it, that they would run with it. Years ago, he used to say, run with the vision. Amen? You remember that BBM? He would say, run with the vision. Catch the vision. All this vision, we were eating the vision. He had drilled it into our hearts and our spirits. For those of you who are new members, my father, the late Bishop Marvin C. Pryor, come on, help me celebrate him as he is rejoicing in heaven today. Come on, help me celebrate him. Sister Gwen Hudson did a remarkable job sharing that. I think, come on, you can do better than that. Help me celebrate all today. I'm going to tell you to another tune. Yes, we thank God for this living legacy and my mother who is yet living, Evangelist Ruth C. Pryor. My mother, I love you. I thank God for you. What a jewel in the house. She'll have an opportunity later today to be able to share on this great occasion what God continues to do. We're excited. I'm extremely excited today. I don't know where to begin. This is one of the first times that I've been really nervous taking the offering. I don't know why. I said, choir, sing another verse. But what joy it is today to be able to come before you. Some of the dreams that we've had and continue to believe of the impact that we will continue to make in our community. Will we be able to buy more coats for children? I went to the school the other day. As I think about it, and I asked, were there some children who needed coats? And there were about 10 that I was thinking that I was going to receive that needed coats. And it was interesting as I received the email, and I'm excited about it, that we're going to be able to buy 50 more coats for the children, because there were 50 children. About 50 children on that list. I looked at it again. I kept scrolling down. I said, wow. So many children are in need of coats, and we were able to get food to Rescue Mission on last week. I want to thank you again so much for being a blessing to Rescue Mission. There's so many different things that's going to allow us to continue to do ministry. Where we'll be able to make sure that we're making a greater impact, continue to do what God has called us to do in the community. So I want to say thank you so very much, because you have believed in the vision. So many of you, and I'll talk about it real briefly on later today, but I've got to say it to our church family. Pastor Chris loves you, and he thanks God for every single one of you. From the bottom of my heart, you have made it easy for me to walk into this position. You've been loving, you've been caring, you've been very supportive. And I want to just say thank you that my eyes can gauge all over this sanctuary to let you know how appreciative I am of each and every one of you. Who have made a great impact in this community to continue to make sure that the vision did not stop, but that it would come to fruition. And so to each of you, from the bottom of my heart, I want to tell you, thank 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 you. I love you with the love of the Lord. She said, Nehemiah 4:6, it said that the people had a mind to work. So I thank God for these people of God who are here. I thank God for each and every one of you to help us build what God has done. I see these mighty men standing before me today, and I just thank God. I want to thank them as senior men to let this young man at the age of 37 come in and to continue to move what I felt that God had given me. thank you, thank you, thank you. I love you with the love of the Lord. Amen. Pastor, we thank you. We know that from the beginning to the end, God knows what's going to be. Many people think that God only operates when things happen. When Adam fell from that holy state, God knew that he was going to send his son Jesus so that man might have a right to the tree of life, might be able to be redeemed. Yes, God gave Bishop the vision. And he knew in 2010 that he was going to call Bishop home. And he also knew that he was going to let the mantle fall on you. This is 2018. That the vision would be carried through, would not falter. God is all knowing God.
To God be the glory. This is a tough day for me. 19 years, 2 months, 13 days since we've been here. And if we're talking about burning a mortgage, I am so proud and honored to stand before you today, Pastor, to say that I've been with this from the beginning. I co-signed with Bishop and Deacon Brodus to come into this entity. And to see how you have took the mantle and ran with it, you know, that says a whole lot, speak a whole lot of volume. I can remember saying at his funeral that we must keep the vision alive. And I see that going forward, you know, and I'm so proud to stand before you today, you know, as a member, you know, and been a member for 34 years, you know, and came in, you know, and all the things that we've done, you know, even the renovation of the old church. I've been a part of it, you know, and I just thank God, you know, for the things that we are continuing to do. I'm getting up in age now, you know. A lot of times, you know, we have to sow into the younger ministry people, you know, and let them take it, the man and run with it. Even as he gave you the vision, people have to catch it. First of all, they have to see it before they can run with it. And so, you know, it's going to take money to keep this church going. It takes a lot of money. And so in order to do the other phases that he wanted to do, it's going to take each and every one of you. Don't be afraid to sow, you know, because that's what it's going to take to get us where we need to be. And so I just thank God for this moment, Pastor, you know, and I love you. Keep on doing what you're doing. And God got your arms. And I can't say I'm behind you, but we are beside you. Because see, when you're behind someone, you can't see where they're going. But as long as we don't get in front of you, you know, that's where we should always be. You know, I thank God.
I give honor to God who's ahead of my life. I thank God for an opportunity to serve Abundant Moses and Joshua. Amen. I thank God that I had an opportunity to come in as the vision was beginning. I seen it in the building stages, and it was an excitement to me because I'd never seen anything like it. I had never been a part of anything like this in before, but I knew that there was something in there for me because what I seen was family. And that what stood out to me the most. Bishop being a husband to his wife and a father to his kids. There was something that I aspired to do, was to be a better dad. And it was a long journey, you know, but just because Bishop transitioned, I refuse to let the vision die. I am sold out to the Lord, but I'm also sold out to the vision that God has placed within him and in his son. I thank God for a wonderful job. Him and his wife working in unison together. The children. The things that have been passed down, the legacy that was left. I thank God for it. I thank God for being a part of this here. And I'm ready for the next phase. God bless you, Pastor.
This is an awesome moment for, you know, my wife and I. You know, because this ministry was God ordained for Robert Littles. And I can't say enough about it. And, you know, I'm just going to be real brief. But your dad, when I was 45, he challenged me to be not to be a public success and a private failure. I was 45, and it was a game changer for me. I just decided to push in the supernatural to be a better husband at that moment. And at the same time, you and your wife were sowing into our daughters. And that's just unreal. And then Mother Pryor just always encouraging me and just sending me cards and whatever, just text messages. And so it's just, I can't say enough about how, you know, the Littles love Pryors. So to be here at this moment is a faith extender for me. So I'm just excited. And, you know, I thank God Almighty for Victorious Believers Ministries.
Thank you. Well, put those hands together. I appreciate it. Thank you for the encouragement. What a blessing. What a blessing it is. Thank God for each and every one of you as men of God, people of God, who have a mind to work. I'm so excited. Before I move forward, I want to acknowledge that yesterday we have been working very hard. Each of us, there's so many people who have been doing a phenomenal job, but I was pleasantly surprised when I walked into my home. I ran into my home, and then once I came out, my big sister was here, there. Evangelist, missionary, Vonda Massey. Come on, stand, big sis. Her and her husband, Elder John Massey. I was so surprised. My heart was overjoyed. See them, come on, remain standing. I'm excited. I just want everybody to see you. They purchased in a new home, and so I understood that they couldn't make it. But my big sis and my big bro came back to be with me on this day. Come on, give them another hand praise. Yes. My big brother Gary helps me so much. He's up there working the sound today. I love you. I thank God for each and every one of you. But I'm elated because there's so many people who have played such a great role in this ministry who have come back on Vision Day. Yeah. My heart is overjoyed to see Elder John Williams, who now resides in Houston, Texas, along with his wife, Dr. Val Williams. Come on, stand. They are here with us on today. She's just a Murda Sanders with us. She's moving right around, but she's here. I see the Pryors. This is my family. I see missionary Linda Pryor and Tracy. God bless you. And Kim, I didn't see. Stan, so glad to see you. What a joy to see my family here. I see my wife. Sister Parr moved to Grand Rapids. She came back on today. What a joy to see you. Unbelievable. I wouldn't have known this. Brother Mark Bryant came back from Dallas, Texas to be with his brother. Man, I love you. I love you. I see the Lewises. I see Sister Porterfield. I just want to say thank you, thank you, thank you so very much for being here with us on today. I may have missed someone. Forgive me, but I want to say thank you. I want to say thank you. The Whites are over there. Come on, help me celebrate. I'm about to take this offering, but it means so much. And then my 94-year-old grandmother, who is a praying woman, Mother Irma Trice, is with me on today. Mother Trice, love you so much. She's always praying, always praying. Thank you so much. Sister Williams, I see you. God, I thank you. I thank you. My cousin Tony, I love you all. I want to say thank you. All righty. Men of God, out of respect to time, let us get the offering. I thought the men were coming up to cut the pastor off when they were walking up. I said, they're cutting me off. And I enjoyed that. And I said, thank you. Thank you so much for the encouraging words. There's so many people that we can thank. And I appreciate you. We're going to unveil the wall of what God has placed on my heart. I want you to sow. This is Vision Day. First, I want you to get your tithes and offering. All righty. I want you to get your tithes and offering. Yes, we are talking about money. It's not to scare people. We talk about money everywhere. I tell you all the time, why does $100 seem so small in the church? Huh? So big in the church? Huh? Isn't it interesting? So $100 seems like it's so big in church, but so small at the mall. And so as we look at our lives, it's so small at the mall, but it's so big in church.
And so today, it is a joy to see my young sons, Carrington and Chandler, here. And I love them. I thank God for my lovely wife. I'm going to ask her to come at this time. I want you to give your tithe and offering. Now, we still take care of everything. We're going to pay off the completion of this after Vision Day in about 2 to 3 days after we get everything together. I want to just say thank God for you. Come on, give it up for your first lady. Come on, ladies. Thank God for her. Thank God for her. Thank God for her. A lady who has a heart and a vision. She allows me. It's fun to go home. I tell you, no excuse. I'm being honest with you. It's a joy to go home. And to be able to go home in a place of peace. And today, as we've done over the last several years, we've been able to sow into this church. I want to ask you to do something that I'm not doing. I'm asking the body of believers to stretch. Isaiah, the 54th chapter, the second verse, it says, stretch for your stakes. As we are enlarging our territory, what are we enlarging? We're going to continue to build more houses and buy more houses in our community. We're about to buy another house on this street of Outer Drive so that a single parent or a mother can family can live in that home. And so we're going to continue to build and make sure that there's a great difference. As we've done the back to school, VSAT, we're building robots in our schools to help our children in mathematics to help them. That's what God has called us to do. That's what the community development means. Today, I'm going to ask you to get your tithes and offering. Today, I don't say it just to hide behind it or to brag or to boast. I'm sacrificing. Today, I'm going to sow again $10,000 into this vision because I believe in the vision. We are going to sow $10,000. Done it for the last several years. I don't publicly announce it all the time. But I want you to know I'm not asking you to do something that we're not doing. We're going to sow $10,000 into this to make sure that we complete this mortgage. We're real close at it, and God is so good. That's why we're burning the mortgage, because we're doing it today. Shout today. God is worthy. I want you to get your tithes and offering, and then what I'll do is we're going to collect the vision in a separate. Oh, it's already ready? All right. Minister Bivens, if you lift your hand, if you have your vision, we'll do it all at once. If you'll put your vision right with Minister Bivens, and then your tithes and offering with the other two. All righty? For the vision, if you'll give it right now and to Minister Bivens, that allow us to go directly to that so that we can take care of God's business. Let us stand. As we're putting the Believer's Confession up there, I want to make sure that I expedite time. We are so grateful unto them that God is so good. Some of you are sacrificing $50. Some of you are giving $100. Many of you have given $500, $1,000. There may be someone else that says, Pastor Chris, I see the vision. I want to sow $10,000, $20,000. You can do that today. All right? I want to take no limits because God is a big God. I have a friend of a pastor that someone walked into the church. He heard the vision of what they were doing, and he sold $40,000 into the ministry right in the state of Michigan. So $40,000, and God blessed them. This is what God is doing when people see the vision and things are being implemented. So as I've said, you know that I'm not hoarding or keeping any of this money. We're sowing it right back into the kingdom of God. All righty? So we give God the glory. If you'll pay attention to the screens, let's say it all collectively together. Dear Lord, thank you that the same power that raised Jesus lives inside of me. And because of this, I know that I can do all things through Christ. I pray that today I'll be surrounded by your favor and that no weapon. Thank you for going ahead of me and making the crooked places straight and the rough places smooth. Father, open doors of opportunity for me that no man can shut. I thank you in advance that my life will be blessed so that I can be a greater blessing to others. May the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be pleasing to you today. And there should be no lack in
this house.
And there should be no lack in
house.
Come on, say it. There should be no lack in
this house.
And there should be no lack in
house.
There should be an abundance in
this house.
And there should be an abundance in
house.
Come on, clap those hands. You believe that today.